The GitHub Custom Steps repository enables customers, partners, and SaaS employees to share custom steps. In this video, you'll learn how to access the repository and how to import custom steps for use in your SaaS Studio environment on SaaSvya. Let's start by downloading a custom step. In a web browser, open the SaaS GitHub repository. https://github.com/saassoftware/saas-studio-custom-steps. To view a list of available custom steps, scroll down and click List of Custom Steps in this repository. The custom_steps_list.md file opens. Notice that each custom step is in its own folder in the repository. Select geodistance with rounding from the list. The steps README file appears. Here you can view the steps interface, learn about what it does, review any requirements, and explore any other information that the custom step developer has provided. The description indicates that this custom step enables SaaS Studio users to calculate the distance between two supplied latitude and longitude locations in either kilometers or miles using the SaaS geodist data step function. It also includes the option to round the result to a specified number of decimal places between 0 and 5. The results are stored in a new column named Distance in Miles or Distance in Kilometers, depending on the distance type option you select. To download this step, navigate to view the .step file and then click the Download button. Now let's use the custom step. Open SaaS Studio on SaaSvya. In the Explorer pane, navigate to the location where you want to upload the custom step. Then right-click and select Upload Files. Navigate to the location of the downloaded .step file, select it, and then click Open. Click Upload. On the navigation pane, click the Steps button. A list of the available custom steps appears on the Shared tab. To view the steps design and program code, right-click Geodistance with Rounding and select Edit in Designer. On the Designer tab, you can view information about the step, including the user interface options and a description. Select the Prompt UI tab to view JSON for the user interface, and select the Program tab to view the code that will execute when you run the custom step. Click the Preview button to view what the step looks like to an end user. Let's use this custom step to calculate the geodistance between two longitude and latitude points. Close the preview window and the custom step designer. To use the step on its own, let's open it in standalone mode. On the navigation pane, right-click Geodistance with Rounding, and then select Open in a tab. The first step is to specify an input table. Click the Input Data button, then navigate to the location of the lat-long table and click OK. The lat-long table contains the input data needed to run the custom step. Notice that you have the option to select miles or kilometers for the distance measurement. Keep the default measurement, miles. Now we need to specify the columns. Click the Add button for location 1. Select country_latitude and country_longitude, and then click OK. Click the Add button for location 2. Select location_latitude and location_longitude, and then click OK. Click the Select a Table button for the output table. Select the SAS DM library and name the table Distance. Click OK. Select the Options tab. Notice that there's an option to round the calculated distance. Leave this option unchecked. Click Run to execute the custom step. The output lists the distance between the two points in miles, with no rounding. Close the custom step. Now let's use the same custom step within a SAS Studio Flow. We'll also add a second custom step, named Send SMTP Email to send email when the results are ready. In SAS Studio, click Build a Flow. On the navigation pane, click the Libraries button. Expand the SAS DM library. Drag the source table, lat-long, to the flow. On the navigation pane, click the Steps button. Select GeoDistance with rounding and drag it to the flow. We need to complete the required fields and specify any options. This time, let's calculate the distance in kilometers and round the result to 2 digits. Select the Kilometers radio button. Click the Add button for location 1. Select country underscore latitude and country underscore longitude, and then click OK. Click the Add button for location 2. Select location underscore latitude and location underscore longitude, and then click OK. Select the Options tab. Select the Round Calculated Distance checkbox. For the number of decimal places to round to, enter 2. On the navigation pane, click the Libraries button. In the SAS DM library, select Distance as the output table and drag it to the flow. We're ready to add the Send SMTP Email custom step to the flow. On the navigation pane, click the Steps button. Select Send SMTP Email and drag it to the flow. Specify who the email is from and to. Also include a subject and the text for the email. Click the Options tab. Set the importance to High. Change the email text color and select the Request Read Receipt checkbox. On the Email Setup tab, enter your SMTP server name and port. Let's add swim lanes to control the execution of the flow. Click the Submission Order button, then select Enable Submission Order. Enter a name for swim lane 1, GeoDistance. Enter a name for swim lane 2, Send Email. Click Save. In the Save As window, name the flow Calculate Distance. Then click Save. Click Run to execute the flow. Let's review the results. On the Navigation tab, navigate to the Distance table and open it. Notice that the results are in kilometers, rounded to 2 digits. The recipient of the email can review the message sent by the flow. The recipient has the option to return a read receipt since that option was selected when we configured the Send SMTP Email custom step. The email contains the text we specified in the flow. Now that you know how to add a custom step from the GitHub repository, I hope you'll try it on your own. Be sure to check out the links in the description for more information about custom steps and the GitHub repository. Thanks for watching this video. Please like it and leave a comment if you found it helpful. And don't forget to subscribe to the SAS Users YouTube channel for more how-to content like this.